Alrighty then, let's do this. Welcome to flow. Today's practice, we're just going to kind of target everything, get in a full body movement practice. So it's possible, I'm gonna try to keep it at 60 minutes, but it's possible that it might run a few minutes late, but I'll try to respect your time. I know you probably have a lot going on, so let's go ahead and begin on the floor, on our backs. And you can stretch all the way out if you want to, but it would also be fine to bend your knees and let your knees come together, or windshield wiper your legs. Arms could reach overhead, or they could just be by your side. Start to bring awareness to your breathing. No need to change anything unless you feel inclined. Perhaps it's just to make it last a little longer. Perhaps it's to invite in a little bit of sound with your breathing. Maybe you want to start to create a little bit of space between your exhales and your inhales. As usual, we'll try to notice how our spine and trunk are relating to the floor. Where are the gaps? Where are the points of contact? Observing sensation without chasing it. Just letting yourself be. We're going to start with just a little bit of somatic movement in the lower body first, targeting around hips and glutes. We'll stretch the left leg out and a little bit wider than the hip, and then your right leg will bend, right foot planting towards the outer edge of your mat. And as you stamp your foot down into your mat, squeeze your right glutes and let your right side pelvis tip off the floor. And you're going to take your pelvis kind of on a diagonal across you as you keep your right ribs down. And then slowly unravel and lay back down. Let your right leg move open like butterfly. Come to the outside edge of your foot. Reset your foot to the ground. Squeeze your buns on that right side and lift and twist the pelvis slightly. You can even let your knee travel inward even more. Maybe the ankle turns. This is the first little flow. So you'll just move at your own pace, widening that hip, coming onto the outside edge and then rolling inward and lifting and twisting. It's possible that your head might like to start to turn as well. Maybe that means when your right leg crisscrosses a little bit and your right hip lifts, you could turn your head to the right or to the left. Try it both ways, see what you think. We'll do two more soft flows here. On the last one, allow for your leg to open all the way up as far as it wants to go. Crisscross inward, lift the right side of your pelvis, and then we're going to hold that little bit of pelvis tipping and maximize hip rotation inward on the right leg. So trying to feel your inner knee, ankle, maybe even the thigh start to turn towards your mat or turn towards your left leg. Reset your body and switch legs. Right leg down, left leg bent. Find your left glutes, lift and twist. Left shoulder stays connected. Sweep it open. Outer edge of the foot. And then we're closing and traveling inward. Try for a couple more. And then let's hold that last one as you pivot inward with a left leg. Let your knee kind of point towards the right big toe. Allowing for a little bit of rotation through that thoracic area. And squeeze your left glute slightly. And then come back to the floor. Take your feet nice and wide. And let's just go both legs wipering now, allowing for your pelvis to move a little bit if it wants. It would also be okay to explore just the hip rotation as well. That might make it more intense. So depending on the amount of sensation you are after right now, one of those two strategies would be more appropriate. Gaze can turn opposite of the legs. And then as the legs go right, left arm's gonna reach across your body and you're gonna kind of roll onto your right side. Reach left arm beyond the right. Come back through the middle. Let your legs twist to the left, right arm's gonna reach across. One more like that each side. And on the next couple of repetitions, we're gonna continue this movement, but come up to forearm. So that left arm's gonna reach up all the way across, right forearm pushes down. I'm gonna keep my head and shoulders off the ground here, but you could come all the way down if you wanted to. Next couple repetitions, we'll add in the push from the forearm up to the palms, and then back to forearm, back to the roll, crisscross the other way to the palm, forearm and down. Let's try to contain through the front side a little bit so it almost feels like we're teasing an abdominal crunch, and do one more to the right and one more to the left. And then we'll just stay up. We'll stay up and find tabletop, working into some wrist, toe, finger, and ankle warm-ups. Start with your toes flat on your mat, tops of the feet. Rock your hips back, find your wrist extension by pulling palms up and flaring fingers. Shift forward, raise your palms and your thumbs, but keep your fingers on your mat. That's the flow, keep it rolling. Keep a straight arm in that wrist extension if you can. finishing off this last set, we're going to hold the palm raises. And then tuck your toes under. Try to get all five toes on each foot connected to your yoga mat. And then flatten your palms and lift through the center. So you just have your five fingertips on the mat and it feels like you're kind of tenting through your palms. Walk your hands back, fingertips towards your knees. Put a little more weight on your toes. If that's going well and you want even a little more sensation, you can take your hands all the way off the ground. And squat on your toes. Actively pushing down with your feet. So you're not just sitting into them, you're also resisting that sit, as if you were to brush your toes back towards the mat behind you. Arms out in front, scapular circles, rolling up, together, down, and then away from each other. Reverse the circle. Try to keep your head still. And then let's get off the toes. Back to tabletop, cat and cow. Start with the tailbone and feel the wave traveling through your spine one piece at a time until you're in the cow. Initiate from the pelvis again and wave into flexion. Head moves last. Establish your own rhythm. Front body stretching in the cow. Front body strengthening in the cat. Back body strengthening in the cow. Back body stretching in the cat. Last one. Lower down to your forearms. Hip cars. It doesn't matter which leg you do, but you are going to do three intentional rotations in each direction with each hip with a closed knee and a level pelvis. And a nice strong push from the shoulders. Button up the front of your rib cage. Try to keep your back nice and steady. Switch sides. And then press back up to tabletop. Step your right foot through. Bring your left knee under your hip and the trunk upright. Left arm shoulder circles. Palm and bicep rolling outward as we go overhead. After you reach your end range, turn your arm inward. Bicep towards your ribs. Palm faces out as you come down by your hip. Reverse it. Lead with your thumb. Maximize internal rotation. Maximize shoulder extension, then roll it outward as you go overhead. We'll cross in front and then reset. Let's try it again. Palm up and away, internal reach. Keep that internal reach behind and then flip it. Cross over. One more time, add a little bit of resistance with the legs too, like you're trying to pull and squeeze them together, especially that left glutes. Ribs stay down. Even the shoulder kind of stays down. Tabletop. And switcheroo, left leg forward. Three shoulder cars. Each progressive rotation, you could add in just a little bit more of that intentional tension or muscular activation, whatever you want to call it, especially in the lower body, to give yourself a little more stability. That means glutes on the back and more hamstrings in the front, as if you're trying to scrub your heel backwards. Let's do one more. A little heavier air on this last one. Tabletop position, but we're gonna walk the knees back just a little bit. So shoulders and hips kind of at the same height, but the knees are behind the hips. And then we're gonna do our scapular retraction and protraction. Elbows straight, moving from the shoulder blades, gliding, and then squeezing and hugging. Five more. Downward dog is next. If your wrists need a little break first, do that. Strong push of the arms, nice high pull of the hips. Decompress spine. Take a trip forward with your feet, please, and maybe we go a little wider for our dangling fold. Generous bend in your knees could feel pretty good. You can hold your arms and sway, or sway and twist. Left hand's going to be on the floor or yoga block. About right underneath your nose, more or less. Take a lengthening twist open with your upper body to the right. Right arm can reach or tuck behind you. And switch it out, same thing. Maybe inhale to lengthen. Exhale to rotate. And then let's find a squat here. It doesn't have to be super low. So if you wanted more support here, we could go yoga blocks underneath the hips, one or two. Just take a little sit and focus on pulling your legs wide apart as you stamp down with your feet. Two arm shoulder cars, both arms out front. Sweep them overhead, keep your ribs down, and then circle sweep and internally rotate as you go behind you. Back up and around. You could crisscross if you want, and we'll just do one more. Hands will land at the heart. I'm going to try to get your spine as upright as you can. Push into your feet, squeeze your buns, and stand straight up. Good. You can set your blocks off to the side. Come to mountain pose. Let's roll through some sun salutations. Take a tall reach. Breathe when it makes sense for you. Tip forward with your pelvis. Spine follows along. Halfway lift. Deeper fold. Plant your palms. Step back to plank. Knees can always come down. We're finding the pulling effort in this plank. Trying to pull the hands to the back of the mat and pull yourself to the floor. Untuck toes. Little cobra. All the way down. A little more work in the back, but you can add in some help with the arms. Cobra or up dog. Take your time transitioning to downward dog. There are many ways. How's your breathing? Lift your heels, walk your feet forward. Inhale, halfway lift. Exhale, fold. Inhale, stand up, reach up. Exhale, hands can come to the heart. And then we'll find that mountain pose once again. Nice and tall through the back. Strong in your legs, reach overhead. Fold in. Get long and strong as you breathe in, halfway. And then fold the trunk down over the thighs. Find your plank. Isometric pulling from the backside of your shoulder, that's gonna take you all the way to the floor again. Strengthen your legs, curl your upper back, cobra or up dog, downward dog. Transition forward with your feet. Halfway lift, that's an inhale. Fold in. Strong backside brings you up, reach up. Let's add side bends. Anything you want to do with your arms. Let's take 2 to 3 breaths focusing on that lateral stretch. Finding that rib cage area lengthening and lifting as you firm up through the seat, the pelvis, and even your inner thighs hugging. Take it the other direction. Some air pull-ups, 2 or 3 with or without a back bend. And then we've got our forward bow. Trying to keep that level back until we're all the way. Then release it. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold. You can find your version of that vinyasa or just a simple step back to downward dog if you're skipping. Stretch your heels off the ground. And then raise your right leg into a splits. Step your right foot through. Runner's lunge, then the back knee comes down. Let's keep our toes tucked. Inhale, come up to a kneeling crescent. Exhale, sweep arms back, tip forward. Raise your back knee. Open all the way to the left to a star pose. Warrior two on your left leg. So we're switching to the back of the mat. Reverse warrior, inhale. Side angle, exhale. Hold here for 2 to 3 breaths. Firm up back leg, fully opening the hip using your seat. Open up to that wide leg stride again. Warrior two to the front now, right leg. Reverse triangle, right leg straightens. Take a long inhale breath. And then as you pivot your hands to the floor, you can start with a bent knee, like a lunge, but then we're working on straightening through the front leg. Maybe your toes feel like lifting off. You could keep your foot pressing down like a gas pedal, depending on what you want for your ankle. And then we're just stepping it all the way up to chair pose from there. Shoulders can be reaching forward and upward. Or you could even take hands to the heart. The deeper you go, the more things change in terms of the load on the thighs, the glutes, even the ankles. Take a forward fold, let your neck relax. Halfway lift, inhale. Exhale, fold, optional vinyasa flow to your downward dog. Downward dog splits with your left leg reaching. Raise your right heel as high as it'll go. Look forward, step forward, pause there for just a moment. Keep your back toes tucked, lightly land your right knee. Kneeling crescent lunge, arms are gonna reach to begin. Breathe in, exhale, arms go back, body reaches forward, the back knee raises up. Inhale, open up to the right. Exhale, warrior B on your right leg. Reverse warrior. Side angle. Extra few breaths here. Trying to balance the effort in both the front leg and the back leg, as if you were trying to guide them towards each other. Inhale, open to that wide star pose. Exhale, left side, warrior two. Inhale, reverse the triangle. Exhale to the long, stretchy pyramid. Front toes can lift or not. Your head could drop. And then we're taking it through our own vinyasa. And we can do that set one more time. Take a tall reach with your right leg. Nice controlled step up. Use your hands if you need to. Back knee down, toes stay tucked. Inhale, rise your arms and spine. Exhale, hinge and reach arms back. Raise your back knee. Inhale, open up left. Find your warrior two left leg. Reverse the warrior two. Your side angle. Inhale, open up star. Exhale, warrior two, right side. Reverse triangle now. Hands to the floor, long pyramid with or without your yoga blocks. This time we're stepping forward to chair pose again. Tip forward and fold. If you want that little half lift in there before you take your vinyasa, that's cool. And then please take the down dog as a reset. Left side, give your left leg a reach. Try to pull your right heel high before you step forward. Back knee down, toes stay tucked. Inhale, kneeling crescent. Exhale, lean forward, arms fly, right leg lifts off the ground. And then open up to the right. Star pose to warrior two on the right. Reverse warrior two. Side angle version. Your in-breath is going to take you back to that open star. Exhale, warrior two, front leg. That's the left. Reverse triangle. Pivot hands down to blocks. Maybe you've got your front toes lifted. It's the long pyramid stride. And then we're going through the vinyasa our way. Okay, let's add some stuff. We're going to be holding some of these poses for just a little bit longer. Step your right foot through. All the way to a high lunge. Or a warrior one, if you like that back foot. Set all the way to the floor with a turnout. That's good too. I'm kind of preferring warrior one lately. As you pivot your body forward, slightly over your front leg, take your arms back behind you. You could keep your shoulders more active by keeping the hands away from each other and just trying to get them to pull in, or you could make that interlaced grip bind if you like it. Do try to snuggle your shoulders down away from your earlobes and reach your fingertips as far away from your shoulders as you can with straight arms. You can keep bending into the right knee deeper and deeper, but almost thinking of a slight cobra. Just in the upper back. Back leg a little straighter. Rise up open to that star pose. Now you're gonna free up the arms and kind of expand through your chest. Warrior two to the left. Pausing, breathing, finding your strongest warrior stride. Keeping your big toe anchored, could we find a little lift of the arch? But maintain a straight leg. Reverse your warrior two. Try to lift up out of your right low back. That's an area of compression sometimes in this pose. Might help to fully extend your right hip by contracting right glutes. Side angle we go. Your expression. Reverse triangle. Shorten your stride. Maybe just one or two heel toes with the right foot. Let's make our triangle from here. Pelvis tips towards your left leg. Reach your spine long. Left hand could be on your block. Bend your left knee. Find your half moon from here. So really pushing off the right foot, teetering your body into that balance. If you find that yoga block helpful, use it. Otherwise, maybe your hand is just hovering off the floor. Warrior three to the back. It's a pivot around your left hip, trying to find a balanced pelvis and spine column. Hands to the heart could be good. Arms could be wide like wings. Step your right foot up to meet your left in mountain pose, back of the mat. Quick switch of the legs. Stand on your right leg now. Bring your left leg forward and hold onto your knee. Squeeze your right leg up into your ribs as far as they'll go. And then take your right arm out to the side. Open your left leg out like you're going to come to tree pose. And then come to tree pose. Place your foot where you want it. Arms can reach up, back, or together. Breathing for three, two. Step open. So you're gonna move the left leg backwards and find a warrior two with your right leg frontwards and your left leg backwards. Pivot open to a wide leg stride. Goddess. Toes out, heels in, we squat. Let's add these crunches we've been doing here in this pose. Hands behind the head, side bend right and left. Trunk stays vertical. Come back to neutral, and now we twist the upper back. Each direction, doesn't matter which way you go first, but don't let your legs go with you. So keep them actively pulling outward. Warrior two to the front, left leg. Reverse the warrior two. Hands to the floor, runner's twist, right hand down, chest open to the left, breathing for five. Okay, we got a side plank on this right hand. So you could come to the forearm if you prefer it, or you're just gonna come onto the knife edge of your right foot and step back. Top arm could reach. Hips are lifting, finding a little bit of that side core containment. Maybe a little stretch on the left side core. And then we have a vinyasa if we want it. Downward dog or a child's pose for a quick break. Resetting breathing. Left side, let's do our warrior one or a crescent. So take your time with those transitions. Maybe it's first runner's lunge for a moment or two. Make sure your legs are where you want them. And then come on up. Take your body forward and your arms backwards. Make a bind if you did on the other side. You're still thinking of sliding your left hip backwards and squeezing a little bit here on the right rear hip, as if your legs could scrunch up your mat. Still a little upper body spine extension. Shoulders a little higher if you want them, fingertips or knuckles reaching back. And then you're going to open up to the right. It's going to be a right side warrior two to the back of the mat. Sorry. We'll get it together. Reverse the warrior two. Side angle pose. Your way, your expression. Reverse your triangle. And then maybe you like that little shortened stance. So your left leg can bump slightly forward, heel toeing. Tip your pelvis first, find the reach of your spine, and then your right hand can land on your block or your shin. But do roll your right shoulder back. Two more breaths in Trikonasana. It's your half moon from here. On the right leg, push into your right foot. Think of tugging your right hip bone backwards and kicking through your left hip. Placing your left footprint on the wall behind you. Find your glutes. Now rotate your body around your standing leg. So around your right leg. Warrior three, hands can come to the heart. Try to find a level pelvis and shoulder, and then the front ribs tend to get away from us. So let's just zip those up real quick. Now step forward with your left foot. So you're going to be at the back of your mat in mountain pose. Tadasana, we're going to switch legs again. So now you'll be on your left foot, bringing your right leg out in front of you, giving it a little tug to help it. So holding the front of the shin or the knee, left arm sweeps out to the left. Now move your right leg open, like a gate opening. Find your tree pose. Place your foot wherever it lands on your leg. That feels just right for you. Arms can reach up, forward, or even back behind you for reverse prayer pose. That's kind of a nice, fun thing to try. So our next stop is going to be stepping the right leg backwards. Warrior two on your left leg. Flip open to a wide leg stance, goddess. Side crunches both ways. Notice the hips want to go with. So can you generate a little bit more stability below? Now we got those little twisty bits up top. Warrior B to the front leg now. It's your right leg. Reverse warrior B. And then you've got your hands to the floor for the open twist. Might need to shuffle your feet a little bit wider. Now you're on your left palm. You could drop to the left forearm eventually. How do you want to get to your side plank? Pushing down and forward with that left hand. Finding your rotation externally with that shoulder. That means bicep turning the same direction as your fingertips. And then a slow slide back to plank. Optional push-ups here if you want them. And then a little back bend for strengthening. Hips go high, down dog. If down dog feels like rest to you, it's a good place to be. If you prefer to drop the forearms, you might find a dolphin pike. Otherwise, child's pose is good. About five breaths. And then let's go ahead and find an open seat to the open edge of your mat, the long edge of your mat, like a straddle. Bump your seat back so that it's towards the back edge. And then let's find about maybe 80% of your maximal width that you could achieve in this abducted position, so you don't have to go all the way. And we're going to do a combination of a little bit of hip rotation and let the pelvis move, and then a little hip rotation without letting the pelvis move. So it's going to look like this. As you lift the right bum, your right thigh bone is going to turn in and the big toe knuckle is going to come down and the pinky toe knuckle is going to lift up. So the pelvis is turning too. And then set to center, lift the left hip, pelvis, turn inward. Now notice your spine wants to move too, so let it. Let there be a little upper T rotation. But while that one leg is moving, don't let the other one move. So keep it set to neutral, so that it's just thigh and hip and pelvis only on one side. And then as we bring the legs in a little closer, we'll also bend our knees. Let's try to keep the hands away from the floor today. We usually set the hands behind us in this position, but we're gonna try for a little bit more active hip movement. So heels wide, wider than the hips. Toes can be up or down. You might try it both ways. It's just a little bit different experience. You're going to keep your front hip points facing the long side of your mat and turn one leg in and all the way out. See if you can keep your ankle straight so that when you do roll your leg in, your inner foot touches, and when you roll your leg out, your outer foot touches. So just one leg and it doesn't matter which one. Pelvis is staying settled. And then we'll go the other way. Or the other leg, rather. Now we're going to turn this into a really slow mobilizing flow. So first thing, we'll rotate that left hip all the way open as far as it'll go. And then you're going to let your right leg turn in and let your pelvis tip so that you can get your legs into that 90-90 position, the pinwheel shape. Little core twist towards the left with an upper body. You can do what you want with your hands. So maybe your hands just kind of pull on the legs. Do try to sit up super tall. For the transition, you're gonna keep your left leg super strong, maybe even pressing into your block or an object. Now open up your right leg as far as it'll go. Yes, so you're trying to turn that right leg open and out. Once you can't go any further with that, let your pelvis help twist you into the opposite position. Now your left leg's turning inward, your right leg is opening outward. And then find that upper body rotation to the right now. Continue to work the right leg open towards the floor. Start to open your left hip. Once you can't get any further, allow the pelvis to move with and switch the legs back to the opposite 90-90. Upper body twist. Right leg only initiates, open. And then allow the rest of the body to move around to the opposite side rotation. This is it. The leg that's turning in needs to open all the way first, and then we transition. Right leg open, follow through, left leg closes, twist, left leg opens, open to the side, right leg closes, twist. Last one, right leg opens, follow through, left leg closes, twist, left leg opens, follow through, right leg closes. Okay, so we're gonna turn this into pigeon from here. So let's just stay with the left leg. Pull your heel in a little closer. If you like this leg position on the right side, you don't have to change anything. You could just actually fold over your left leg right here for the pinwheel or the Z stretch. But if you wanted your pigeon, you would shoot your right leg straight back behind your hip so that you're on the top of your knee and the top of your foot. You could snuggle some support underneath your left hip if you don't want to get super deep in this. Option to back bend in your pigeon. Option to twist your pigeon. And if you like that folding sleeping pigeon, keep a little bit of energy in the hips as if you were at just like a level 1 out of 10, trying to squeeze your legs right towards your midline, front to back. Two more breaths in the more relaxed state of pigeon. And to polish the side off, we're gonna keep the legs in our pigeon. Plant the hands, lift your chest slightly, and then tuck your back toes. Raise your back knee off the ground and fully extend your right hip. Think of just a little tuck under, like you're doing cat pose with your whole body. And then lower your knee, bring it in a little ways. Untuck your toes, press your foot down. See if you can do the pigeon without your hands. Arms can go back, really press through your front shin and squeeze through your right bum. Little balance test here. And then you can set your hips down, roll open to the right side pigeon, or the pinwheel. Choosing your version first to be more yin-like, a little stillness, some softness, just a microscopic squeezing of the muscles around the hip, just as a way to take ownership of this position, to claim strength and this depth. Reconnect palms to your mat, rise your chest. Body is still on a diagonal. Tuck your back toes, raise your knee, and then create a little bit of a cat pose, spinal flexion, and squeeze your left tush. Ground your left knee, untuck your toes. You can shorten your stride a little bit, so your hips are going to be higher off the ground. Press down through the front leg shin. Arms can fly. See if you can hover your pigeon. Squeezing your legs towards each other. Roll to your right hip. Sweep your left leg around to the front. Butterfly, Baddha Konasana, cobbler, whatever you want to call it. Soles of the feet together. They could be pretty close to you, or they could be far away. Widen out your stride with your legs, and then you can tip forward any amount. At the end range of your stretch, just allow for some softness. That could be only in the head, maybe it's in the upper back. Connect to a sense of filling up the back of the ribs. A deep and low breath to the posterior chain. Traveling your attention up and down the length of your spine.
on both sides. Maybe you can even connect that to your nostrils. In through the left, down the left side, up through the right side of the spine and out through your right nostril. Just an energetic practice. And you can reverse that, inhaling through the right and your mind going down the right side of your back, making a U-turn, pulling that energy up through the left side of your spine and out through your left nostrils. Kind of a circular breath.
Okay, let's come on up to seated. Both legs will shoot forward. Wiggle yourself forward on your mat so you have plenty of room to lay back behind you. Have a yoga block nearby. And we'll lower down slow, segmentally flexion in the spine as we roll. Articulating each vertebra best we can. Bend your knees, set your feet. Slow articulation up to your bridge pose for 5 breaths, working bridge. And then you can use your yoga block to support the hips either in a bridge or a reverse process with the legs up, or extended bridge with the legs stretched all the way to the ground. Relax around neck and shoulders, throat, jaw. Set your hips back down on the block if they're not already there. Do take your legs up and bend your knees to about 90 degrees. Maintain a pretty vertical thigh bone. It doesn't have to be perfect. And then start your internal hip rotation with both legs at the same time. Now your knees don't have to be touching. It might feel better to have them a little separated, but spiral so that the tops of your thighs start to face inward towards each other and your heels will pivot out. And we're just going to hold this position and find an easeful breath. We're going to keep the internal hip rotation on both legs. With your left leg, start to lower it towards the floor. Tap your toes down. If they don't want to touch, if you feel your low back trying to curl, then don't go that far. And then bring your left leg back up and maintain hip rotation. 2 more times on the left side. Really slow transition to the floor for a tap. And then bring it back. Last one. Stay out of the back bend. Keep those front ribs snuggled in. And then we'll do the same thing with the right leg. Knee stays bent the same amount, and we move from the hip. Last one. Reset feet for neutral bridge stance. Rock your pelvis under. Tailbone curls off the mat first. Find your bridge once again. Give your glutes a good squeeze. And then lay your spine down piece by piece. Left leg is going to extend all the way down. Right leg can pull in. And then you can arrange your legs however you want them for a spine twist. Some of you might like to just draw that right leg across. I personally like to move my hips over to the right a little bit and then stack my legs. Right shoulder and rib cage, just trying to relax towards your mat. Take your gaze in whatever direction satisfies your neck. Spine twist the other direction. If you wanted to start with that little leg pull, you could do that. Left leg snuggles in. Then find that opposite side twist. Breath might feel a little different in this rotation, so maybe you can use your mind to direct it in those hard to reach spots. Back of the left ribs, back of the right ribs, low back. Try to keep it out of your neck and out of your shoulders and upper chest. And then if there's anything else that you think your body could benefit from before you take your shavasana, you can go for that now. And when you feel satisfied with all of that, let's take a rest. You've earned it. Situate your most comfortable final pose. Take a few clearing breaths. Lately, I've been thinking three. One for the body, one for the mind to create some space in the thoughts, and one for the spirit or the soul or the heart, allowing expansion and growth. And set yourself free to just be here. Take rest. keep your body super chill, relaxed, at ease, resting deeply. Points of contact observed, non-contact points also being witnessed, and feeling, connecting to a full-bodied breath, gathering up what you need today from that inhale, kind of energy you want to infuse your day with. And then the exhale can be like that shedding of extra, letting go of what feels a little bit heavier today, clearing the slate in your mind, starting fresh. A few more in and outs. Any movement that inspires you from there. Start it slow. A little rocking and rolling might be nice. Twisting. Ankles and wrists spiraling. You could roll onto one side and curl up, or just round up your back to cannonball for a little rock. You can meet me in a seat when the time's right. Checking in, assessing the state of your mind, fluctuation of the thoughts, body sensation. How's your breath? As always, I'm so thankful that you're here with me today practicing this beautiful discovering practice. It's always my honor to guide you. I hope you have an awesome weekend. Take care of yourselves. Namaste.